My name is Nataly. I'm 27 years old. I came in 5 years ago to California and decided to start my journey here, although I started studying architecture in Syria in 2010. But as you guys know, the civil war started, so I couldn't actually complete it, so I stopped for like the first year. I finished it, and then I moved to Jordan to complete my degree, which is next to Syria, like far a little bit, but not that far. And I finished 3 years of architecture, so total of 4 years. And then things happened, and my family decided to come in here. And then for that, I decided to go with my family because they are the big support for me and I won't leave them by themselves. So I start from scratch at Norco College. I start taking general education at Norco College and I was not able to speak English that well. I was not talking to anyone at all. And then from that, it was the faster way to get involved with people is to do volunteering at school. Although I wasn't having any paperwork to work or get paid. So I decided to volunteer at the Learning Resource Center, LRC, what usually students tutor in there. And I decided to tutor what I'm really comfortable with, which is engineering classes. Because the first class I took in here was engineering. Why? Because it's the thing that I really know about. And then from that, I helped students and I get involved with all the students at Norco College. And I start learning English and I start talking to them more. And I got an opportunity also to work as a student ambassador at the school. And I start volunteering in a lot of different areas at school at Norco College. And then I got the opportunity to work at EOPS as well as a student aide. So I literally worked everything at Norco College here. I think that was the faster way to learn English, to learn the culture, to get involved with people, to understand everyone that has a different stories in here, and to get involved with like little things at Norco College. And from there, I learned like my skills get better and better. My English, a little bit good accent than before. You don't want to listen to my accent before. It was terrible. And then the STEM also helped me a lot in like my career, how to apply to schools, how to get in school that I want to be in. Cal Poly was the best school for me because it's next to my house here. I can drive and come back to home and not like traveling and pay more for my tuitions and stuff. And also, it's a good school like architecture. So I wrote a plan for me. I want to go to this school. No matter what, I'll go and I'll get accepted to it. And literally, they helped me in my application. And it was great. I got accepted. And I did my portfolio and they accepted me at the second year, which is a little bit better than the first year. And I have still 2 more years to graduate. I'll be graduating in 2021. Architecture will take 11 years to be graduated from this major. It's a lot, I know, and sometimes I feel down what I'm doing. I've been studying this major for a bunch of years, and everyone is graduating, everyone is having fun except me. I'm still at the same spot I've started. But you know what? I'm on my way to success. I have 100% sure that I'll be successful one day. And guess what? Yesterday I was doing an interview in a company and for a part-time job, and it's a huge company. And I did also last week another interview in another company, and it's a really big company too. And now I need to choose which one I want to go through. They are not choosing me. I want to choose which one I want to go to. So I think I am on my way to go to successful. And It's nice to feel like you're doing what you want to do. I know sometimes I feel like I'm a little bit alone because I'm not having fun that much. I'm not going out with my friends. I'm not enjoying all the time going out like everyone's do. But I have a goal and I want to focus on. I have to focus on it because that's my only way to be successful. No one will care if you're successful or not. You should care about yourself. You should support yourself. You should always, always be the one that will support yourself. Talk to someone that will support you too. Maybe one of your family member, maybe a close friend that she'll always give you positive thoughts. Don't be with the negative people who will, oh, why are you doing that? That's waste of time. Why are you going to school? School is not important. Listen, maybe school is not important for them, but for you, it will teach you something. It's not only about subject 1 + 1 = 2. No, it's about life. You will talk to professors. You will get experience from them. They have a lot of different stories. I was involved with a lot of different professors, and I till now keep talking to them and I contact them. And I sometimes ask for their advice. They help me to what, for example, company is better for me, because they know my personality. They know how people think in here, you know? So friends, yeah, sure, we're friends. I love you. You love me. We're great together. But you don't know what I'm looking for. Be yourself. Try to go for... like, go today and write what you want in this life, what you want to do. Maybe you will just take Norco College as your path, and then you'll stop and move forward. It's okay, but at least put a goal that you want to go and achieve. Always go forward. Never look behind. Never look like, oh, I have a lot of different things. I cannot do it. It's hard for me. Whatever story you guys have, I know it's hard. But you can do it if you want to. No one will push you to do it in like a short time. You have the whole time. I 11 years of architecture. It's too much, too much. All my friends graduated and back home from Syria, and they always ask me, when are you gonna graduate? Which is a sensitive question for me. But you know, guys, what I know what I'm doing. I'm gonna achieve what I wanna do, and I'm gonna like arrive 100% sure, but it's gonna take time. We need to be patient about it. We need to enjoy the tiny moments that we're going through. Yeah, sometimes I cry, sometimes I feel down, sometimes I don't want to do my project, and I did it. Like, literally, I went to my school and was like, I didn't do anything. I don't feel doing anything. But the next day, I got all my stuff ready, and my professor was like, okay, look where you were, and now you're already done. So it's about be patient about yourself, love yourself, support yourself. Be around people who will support you, not the one who will, like, don't do it, and negative people. No, be with positive people. They are all the way. Try to talk to them. Stop cell phoning. Try to talk to people. Try to meet people. Sometimes you are at the elevator, and then you are on your phone. Okay, we all do this, but sometimes you will find someone at the elevator might help you a lot, and you never know. Give them an opportunity. Talk to them. Listen to them. Get involved to school. I think that what I did, and I am already on my way, and I believe that's the way of success in a way. There's a different ways, but that what I use, and I'm still using that. So I encourage you guys to do the same or maybe similar to it, and I wish you all the best. And yeah, that's pretty much my story in a very short term. Thank you.